स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी सी स्टैंडर्ड 9th यूनिट 4 साइंस यूनिट 4 इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज एंड इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. लाइक मास एंड लेंथ, इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज आल्सो इज अ फंडामेंटल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ऑल मैटर. वी नो दैट मैटर इज मेड अप ऑफ एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स. एटम्स आर पार्टिकल्स लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स. By nature, electrons and protons have negative charge and the protons have negative and positive charge respectively, and neutrons do not have charge. An electric current consists of moving electric charges. Electricity is an important source of energy in the modern times. Now we will see about the electric charges. Electric charges are made up of positive charges and negative charges. When these charges flow in a circuit, a current is produced. If an electron is removed from the atom becomes positively charged, then it is called a positive ion. If an electron is added in excess to an atom, then the atom is negatively charged and it is called negative ions. When you rub a plastic comb on your dry hair, the comb obtains power to attract small pieces of paper, is it not? When you rub the comb vigorously, electrons from your hair leave and accumulate on the edge of the comb. Your hair is now positively charged as it has lost electrons, and the comb is negatively charged as it has gained electrons. Now we see about the measuring electric charge. Electric charge is measured in coulomb, and the symbol for the same is capital C. The charge of an electron is numerically a very tiny value. The charge of an electron is the fundamental unit with a charge equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. This indicates that any charge has to be an integral multiple of this fundamental unit of electron charge. Practically, we have microcoulomb, nanocoulomb and picocoulomb as units of electric charge. 1 microcoulomb equal to 10 power minus 6 coulomb, 1 nanocoulomb equal to 10 power minus 9, and the picocoulomb is 10 power minus 12 coulomb. Electric charge is relative in nature. The total electric charge of a system is the algebraic sum of all the charges located in the system. For example, let us say that the system has two charges, plus 5 coulomb and minus 2 coulomb. Then the total or the net charge on the system is plus 3 coulomb. Now we'll see about the electric force. Among electric charges, there are two types of electric force. One is attractive and the other one is repulsive. The like charges repel and the unlike charges attract. The force existing between the charges is called electric force. These forces can be experienced even when the charges are not in contact. We see about the electric field. What is electric field? The electric lines of force are straight or curved paths along which a unit positive charge tends to move in the electric field. We will see about the electric potential. Though there is an electric force existing among the charges, they are still kept together, is it not? We now know that in the region of electric charge there is an electrical field. Other charges experience force in this field or vice versa. There is a work done on the charges to keep them together. This results in a quantity called electric potential. What is electric potential? Electric potential is a measure of work done on unit positive charge to bring it to that point against all the electrical forces. We see about the electric current. When the charged object is provided with the conducting path, electrons start to flow through the path from higher potential to lower potential region. Normally, the potential difference is produced by cell or a battery. When the electrons move, we see that an electric current is produced. That is, an electric current is formed by moving electrons. Now, let us see about the direction of current. Before the discovery of the current, scientists believed that the electric current consisted of moving positive charges. Although we know this is wrong, the idea is still widely held, as the discovery of flow of electrons did not affect the basic understanding of the electric current. The movement of positive charge is called conventional current. The flow of electrons is termed as electron current. In electrical circuit, the positive terminal is represented by a long line, and the negative terminal is a short line. Battery is the combination of more than one cell. Now, it's about the measurement of electric current. We can measure the value of current and express it numerically. What is current? Current is the rate at which charges flow past a point on a circuit. That is, if Q is the quantity of charge passing through a cross section of a wire in time t, quantity of current is represented as I equal to Q by t. Which instrument is used to measure current? Yes, ammeter is used to measure current. What is ammeter? Ammeter is an instrument used to measure the strength of electric current in an electric circuit. Now we see about the electromagnetic force. Imagine the two ends of water pipe filled with water or connected. Although filled with water, the water will not move or circle around the tube on its own. Suppose you insert a pump in between the pump pushes the water. Then the water will start moving in the tube. Now the moving water can be used to produce some work. We can insert a water wheel in between the flow and make it to rotate and further use that rotation to operate machinery. We see about the potential difference. The potential difference is represented by the symbol of V. So V equal to W by Q, whereas W is work done. The Q is amount of charge measured in coulomb. The SI unit of both EMF and potential difference is same, that is the volt, capital V. Voltmeter is an instrument used to measure the potential difference. To measure the potential difference across the component in a circuit, the voltmeter must be connected in parallel to it. You want to measure the potential difference across the light bulb, you need to connect the voltmeter. We see about the resistance. By using this picture, we understand the resistance. In this picture, why we are using tap? Yes, to control the flow of water. In the same way, to control the amount of flow of current in a circuit is by the resistance. The SI unit of resistance is ohm with a symbol. 1 ohm is the resistance of component when the potential difference of 1 volt applied across the component drives a current of 1 ampere through it. Fixed resistors have fixed value of resistance, while the variable resistors like rheostats can be used to obtain desired values of resistance. We see about the electric circuit diagram. To represent an electrical wiring or solve problems involved in the electric circuit, the circuit diagrams were made. The four main components of any circuit or cell connecting wire, switch and resistor or load. Here some of the common symbols in an electrical circuit are given to go through this electrical circuit symbols. Now we see about the different electrical circuit. There are two types of electrical circuit, one is series circuit and other one is parallel circuit. First we will see about the series circuit. In a series circuit, the components are connected one after another in a single loop. In a series circuit, there is only one pathway through which the electric charge flow. From the above, we can know that the current one all along the series circuit remains same. That is, in series circuit, the current in each point of the circuit is same. In the next picture, that is parallel circuit. In parallel circuit, the components are connected to the EMF source in two or more loops. In the parallel circuit, there is more than one path for the electric charge to flow. In a parallel circuit, the sum of the individual current in each the parallel branches is equal to the main current flowing into or out of the parallel branches. Also, in the parallel circuit, the potential difference across separate parallel branches were seen. We see about the effects of electric current. When current flows in a circuit, it exhibits various effects. The main effects were heating, chemical and magnetic effects. Now we'll see about the heating effect. When the flow of current is resisted, generally heat is produced. This is because the electrons while moving in the wire or resistor suffer resistance. Work has to be done to overcome the resistance, which is converted into heat energy. This conversion of electrical energy into heating energy is called joule heating. This forms of the principle of all electric heating appliances like iron box, water heater, toaster, even connecting wires offer a small resistance to flow of current. That is why almost all electrical appliances, including the connecting wires, are warm when used in an electric circuit. We will see about the cation. The heating effect and the chemical effect experiments have to be performed only with the DC cell of around 9 volt. Students at any cost should not use the main domestic electric supply, which is 220 volts AC voltage. If it is used yet, it will give a heavy electric shock leading to a severe damage to our body. We will see about the magnetic effect of electricity. A wire or conductor carrying current develops a magnetic field perpendicular to the direction of the flow of current. This is called magnetic effect of the current. Now we'll see about the types of current. There are two distinct types of current. One is direct current and the another one is alternating current. First we will see about the direct current. No current in electrical circuit is due to the motion of positive charge from higher potential to the lower potential or electron from the lower to higher electrical potential. Electrons move from negative terminal of the battery to positive of the battery. Battery is used to maintain the potential difference between the two ends of the wire. Battery is one of the sources for the DC current. The DC is due to the unidirectional flow of electric charges. Some other sources of DC are solar cells, thermocouples. Many electronic circuits use DC. Some examples of devices which work on DC are cell phones, radio, electric keyboard, electric vehicles. Now we see about the alternating current. If the direction of the current in a resistor or in any other element changes direction alternately, the current is called and alternating current. The alternating current varies sinusoidally with the time. This variation is characterized by the term called frequency. What is frequency? Frequency is the number of complete cycle of variation gone through by the AC in 1 second. In AC, the electrons do not flow in one direction because the potential of the terminals vary between high and low alternatively. Thus, the electrons move to and fro in the wire carrying alternating current. Domestic supply is in the form of AC. When we want to use electrical device in DC, then we have to use a device to convert AC to DC. The device used to convert AC to DC is called rectifier. I will see about the advantages of AC over DC. The voltage of AC can be varied easily using a device called transformer. The AC can be carried over long distance using step-up transformers. The loss of energy while distributing current in the form of AC is negligible. Direct current cannot be transmitted as much. The AC can be easily converted into DC, and generating AC is easier than DC. The AC can be produced electromagnetic induction, which is useful in several ways. Let me see about the advantages of DC. Electroplating, electrorefining and electrotyping can be done only using DC. Electricity can be stored only in the form of DC. Now we will see some of the dangers of electricity and precautions to be taken. The following are the possible dangers as for the electric current is concerned. First one is overheating cables. Due to excessive current flowing in the wire, the cable could overheat. The insulating layer could melt and emit poisonous fumes and even catch fire. Next one is the damp conditions. We have to avoid using damp or wet conditions because water is an electrical conductor. We have to make sure our hands are dry, otherwise the live current will run through us and could be fatal. The last one is beyond the reach of children. The electrical sockets are to be kept away from reach of little children who do not know danger of electricity. Thank you, students.